What up, welcome to FlyVisionsTV, where we keep doing fly shit even when the camera stops. It's your host, Ty McFly, here with my special guest, my guys, Los&nutty.
Los&nutty, WB Nutty.
Pussy-ass niggas gonna move on.
Bitch playing games, don't wanna put it in.
The White House shit.
They say I got a 10, but it's smacked up with
cut. What up, buddy?
How y'all doing today? How's y'all time in the city?
Enjoying Boston, man. Nice city, man.
Y'all here on some like vacation shit? Y'all working?
We just came to do all that for real. Everything, man. Work. Never vacation, though. We just came to see what the city of Boston got to offer, man. Should have been all around the world. You had to come stop here.
Yeah, I feel you. This y'all first time out here?
Yeah, mad love in Boston, too. First time Boston, long way.
Okay. What have y'all experienced? I hear y'all been to the club, y'all experiencing the shorties out here, anything like that?
Man, we ain't been to the club yet. They got some nice shorties, though, out here, man.
Yeah, definitely mad diverse. I hear y'all met some K-Radians yet?
What's that?
K-Radians, it's a whole community of people there from Africa. But the shorties are bad,
we ran to that shit.
In Detroit, but like nationalities different. Is out there.
Yeah, we ain't got no shit called. What's that called?
K-Radians.
They don't label themselves like that. That's
we got like Arabs and shit.
Okay.
You got Middle Eastern motherfuckers. We don't got no like African shit like that, bro.
Okay, now that's lit. So let's talk about the Detroit music scene. It's been getting like a lot of buzz lately, you know, like all around the world. It's definitely starting to spread more time than ever.
Sure.
How y'all feel about that? How y'all feel about the love?
That shit tight, man. That shit live as hell. That shit tight, man. Everybody finally getting all the work they finally putting in, kicking in now.
Mm-hmm.
That shit live.
So y'all saying like y'all been working?
Don't even say Detroit. Yes, it's more than Detroit too.
Okay.
Back then it was just Detroit, but now you got Flint, you got Grand Rapids and shit. You got a lot of other cities other than Detroit making noise right now, making money and shit. So
Pontiac,
you feel me? It ain't just Detroit right now.
Okay, and where exactly y'all from?
We from Detroit.
And so we're talking about y'all from Daisy Lane, right?
So what
is Daisy Lane? Because I ask a lot of people, like, yo, what's some questions I should ask them? And even me, I always wonder, like, where is Daisy Lane? Like, if I pull up to Daisy Lane, if I search that on my GPS, like, I'm going to find it? Like,
Daisy Lane, man, that shit.
You just got to figure it out, bro.
Yeah, you know.
Feel me?
Okay.
I can't give you, a real answer to that. You just got to figure it out.
All right. And now, y'all music style, it's definitely real different. Not like everybody else, you know? Where some of y'all maybe influences or... How do y'all, just where y'all style come from?
I don't know. I can't say it came from no certain artist or no listening to this type of shit, because the shit I listen to don't sound like none of the music I make. But, I mean, we like the old school shit, but I don't know. That shit just, sorry to explain. That's just our style. Our
sound come from just like who you is. You feel me?
Yeah.
What kind of person are you?
Definitely.
You want to sing on the track? What you want to do? You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
That's a good question, though.
Yeah, and I noticed that you said the old school. That's definitely like the type of feel I get, cause like even my pops with me, like my pops even hip to the Detroit music scene now. You feel me? He really fuck with y'all, and he gets like a Tupac type of vibe. You feel me? Just like
Easy E.
Yeah. Somebody said as well. Cause y'all are more so like speaking. It's like y'all are talking on the track.
Yeah.
So like, what's the vibe like in the studio for y'all? Like, is it more of a lit scene or like?
No, I ain't looking for no lit ass studio scene.
That's why
I'm looking for my privacy for real.
Yeah, that's why the music ain't no dance music. They ain't like no shit where you trying to. It's really like some reality shit, like really what's going on and what a motherfucker going through, what the hood going through, shit like that type shit.
Real life shit.
It's not no music to make you. If some people might get a dance off to or whatever, but it ain't that type of. That ain't what the target is though. It ain't no dance music. It's like some reality music.
Okay, and so what is y'all target? Who do y'all make music for, obviously, other than yourself?
Everybody.
Okay. Ain't like, I'm not excluding nobody out this.
That's
shit.
What I'm saying. If you can get it,
it ain't just for a nigga who's selling dope.
Yeah,
I tell you that.
Yeah, that's
I don't fuck what you do. You can sell motherfucking shoestrings and shit.
Right.
It's for whoever's selling shit.
Real hustle,
hustling the shit you do.
Yeah, no, I definitely hear that.
Go to work. It's for you. Feel me?
And so since y'all been on the music scene, since y'all grown, you know, got more popular and stuff like that. What's one moment that has happened, you know, in y'all journey that really is a highlight for y'all?
Everything happens so fast.
You got
fast,
good ass questions, dog.
Everything happens so fast. Everything is a highlight, bro. Every day, every time, it's a highlight for us, bro. We go through some new shit every day. Motherfuckers we used to play the video game with we cool with. Nah, you know, I'm play basketball, NBA games, when we in contact with them, shit, life just different, right? Yeah. Every day is something new with this shit, because we ain't rap new to it, so, you know what I'm saying? Every day is something new, and every day is some...
And rap being
every
new.
Day is a highlight.
Okay.
Honestly.
Like some movie type shit.
I like that ring. Let me see that ring.
Motherfucker bussing.
I like that. I like that right there.
Motherfucker bussing, man.
So when did you guys start rapping?
Probably about 2 years ago.
2019, like. What is it 2021 right now?
Yeah.
Let me say like December 2019.
What made y'all start rapping? What made y'all start writing and hopping the studio?
We didn't even write for one. It just was our people got a studio. We be in the studio.
Babyface Ray, man.
Fucking around, yeah.
Honestly.
Yeah.
If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be rapping at all.
So he was just telling y'all, like, yo, like, come on, like.
That nigga paid for our first video. Mm. Like, y'all wanna shoot a video? He just called us to pull up. I'm like, what the fuck, what's going on? Cameraman out there, I'm like, what the fuck going on?
Yeah.
We shoot the video? All right,
bro. Some shit, we was just bullshitting on, like, yeah. Song, our first song, Kid, we was just bullshitting on. Motherfuckers like that shit, so we ended up getting shot. After that, it was on.
Yeah.
And then, so when did y'all really start taking it serious? Cause you know, a lot of niggas rap, you get what I'm saying? But it's like, what's that moment where it's like, bad, like being like.
They was fucking with really that first, they was fucking with that first song, that's what it was for real.
Okay, so y'all was like, damn, like, we might as well, yeah.
My first serious thing was like the first paid feature I got though.
Okay.
Nigga paid me like, yeah. My first one was $1,000, you feel me? In Grand Rapids, I drove to that bitch and went and grabbed that shit, went right back home. Like, dang, who next?
Yeah, fact. Yeah. That's lit. So, y'all last projects, y'all have both had recently solo projects as well.
Yeah.
You have a narcotics recently dropped,
yeah.
And you had Fuck the World,
yeah,
correct?
Fuck the World, yeah.
How do y'all feel those projects went?
Shit. Honestly, Narcotics 9 is my favorite project so far.
Yeah, that's my favorite project by Nutty too, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite projects right there.
You feel like it got good feedback and stuff like that?
Yeah, hell yeah, and I ain't done painting a picture for it yet. You know, sometimes you put a CD out, they want to see a video of it, you know, and I got to really kind of paint a picture exactly what I'm talking about. So I haven't even really did that yet, and they fucking with it. So once I really get into that, it's going to really do what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, it's a crazy time, and visuals really count. How about you? How you feel like Fuck the World went?
It went good. It went real good, actually, like on the number side, but I'm on to the next, though.
Okay.
I ain't dwelling on that shit. I'm going to the next thing. I ain't celebrating none of that. Really.
I feel you.
I got something next, ready right now.
Okay. And y'all feel like y'all solo projects do better or y'all joint projects do better?
And they all do, you know.
Ain't no better.
Okay. We having fun with that shit, so we don't even be thinking about it. Like, they just be like, put this out, you know. We got so much shit, we work so much that we keep this shit going every week. We really just sit.
Really holding back for real.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know y'all probably got mad shit in the cut. Just holding on, waiting. So what's up with y'all waiting for? When we about to be finna get
25 Inches Volume 2 coming out soon.
Okay.
Shit, a lot of shit coming out.
Looking out for that, got a lot of features on that from all around the world and shit too.
Mm-hmm. And how y'all
Green
feel like?
Green from New Orleans Part 2.
Green from New Orleans Volume 2. I gotta wait for that though, man.
Wait for that one?
Yeah.
How long? Like, what? When do you think that one's about to drop?
Probably like October.
Huh. That fuck around be an album, start being turned into an album type thing, I feel like.
Mm-hmm.
Everything else be like mixtape, you know, you just spit that shit out.
I'm really working on that. Yeah. I had the bitch done though.
You feel
honestly.
Me?
Taking your time with it.
I went back to the drawing board and like I'm scratching all that shit.
Nah, I definitely hear that. I noticed all y'all got the Daisy chains. Does that flower mean anything else rather than literally just being Daisy Lane or?
That's what it is, Daisy Lane. It's our life, Daisy Lane Records. This is what it is, the life change.
You gotta know what it is to know what it is.
Like y'all said before, if you know, you know. And is that something you gotta be a part of it to know? Or?
No. Yeah, there's motherfuckers all around the world being a part of this shit right now. You feel me? Okay. There's so many motherfuckers around the world who can go buy a Daisy chain right now, and I won't be like, oh, what the fuck you doing with a Daisy chain? I'm like, yeah, that's my nigga.
Mm-hmm. You got you a good thing going somewhere, and you making some good money.
You one, man.
And you get up, and that's what you do every day. You get the most out of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's your Daisy chain. Go get you a Daisy chain. I don't know if it's a spot. Work, whatever.
Okay.
That's your day, man.
And y'all said y'all recently started rapping, so like before rap, before like this makes sense, like what was y'all playing?
What was the plans?
Yeah.
I was fucking around with engineering though. I was gonna probably get into the music business regardless I wanted to. But I ain't have plans on it getting, you know what I'm saying, getting people to live, but
who knows though? You know, nobody really knows what it's coming.
Get money.
Could have, should've, would've. Yeah, get money.
I always say, I don't know what I'll be doing, or I don't know how I'll be doing. Well, I know what I'll be doing though. I don't know how I'll be doing it, but I know what I will be doing though.
Let me do
if it wasn't for this shit, like I'll be doing it. I'll still be
get
doing
some
it.
Money.
Getting this shit happen, making this shit happen. So
nah, hear that. Well, thank y'all, you feel me, for definitely letting me come chop it up with y'all. What's up? You think you could drop, like, you feel me, a little unreleased, you feel me? I know you say you're on freestyle.
I'm not a freestyler, bro.
Something?
I feel like I'm too serious to be busting freestyles and shit, bro. You feel me? I tell you, bro, like, we never in our lives is freestyle. I mean, I ain't gonna say that, bro.
So if it was up to y'all, you feel me, Daisy Lane Records running the world, what's that?
That's what it is. Okay. They gonna see it real soon.
Niggas got about 90 days, bro. They get their shit together.
Alright.
Questions down the line.
Say that.
One thing you gotta know, we ain't tired at all. We don't sit still.
And like y'all said, y'all just getting started.
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 10%.
Just 10?
Yeah.
10% for sure.
I say that. Well, thank you for coming and chop it up. You already know I appreciate y'all.
What's up, my boy?
Nice to meet y'all.
Appreciate you having us too.
You're already. Thank you for tuning in to FlyVisionsTV. Catch us next week.
What up? This your boy Los&nutty, man.
Y'all go tap in with my boy Ty at FlyVisionsTV, man, in Boston. Get y'all right, man.
Let's get it.
That's what you're on. Streaming like the dope man. Top niggas, top dollar for the. I'm coming with you. It's time to press niggas. Don't let up on them. Hair wine, table high. Here to get the best of you.